This is a pawpaw tree.
It's actually a funny story how I learned about these trees and was able to find some. Remember the zebra swallowtail? Well, that's what led me to the discovery of this tree and how I was able to know exactly where to find some, because it turns out that the zebra swallowtail exclusively lays its eggs on pawpaw trees. So, I went out to find some near to where I found this butterfly, and sure enough, there were bunches of them everywhere, and I hadn't even noticed them. Here in my backyard, basically, my whole life, were the largest edible fruits indigenous to the United States, and I had no idea about them. These fruits taste like a mixture of banana and mango and smell like pineapple. Crazy, I know. They actually used to be a big part of cultivation, but their popularity died down when Americans no longer had to go to the woods for food. Also, coupled with the fact that these fruits don't ship well and are easily bruised. The earliest documented event of the pawpaw was in 1541 by a Spanish explorer named Hernando de Soto, who found Native Americans cultivating it. The word pawpaw is believed to be derived from papaya by explorers from the Caribbean areas who were familiar with the papaya fruit and thought it looked similar. This clip was from episode 8 of Snap de la Nature. Check out the Snap de la Nature YouTube channel or the Facebook page to watch the full episode and to follow me along on my journey as this show grows as fast as a cottonwood.